A quick kick. This will be Colquitt on a third down quick kick, and it sails over the head of the receiver and comes rolling down where it will be covered by Tennessee, and that punt is good for 64 yards. There's timeout on the field. The score, Tennessee nothing, Georgia Tech nothing. You'll see the Volunteers just go down to the ground and take out the forward thrust of the offensive line, but there it is, right on top of the goal line, third down. Georgia Tech nothing, Tennessee nothing. Levette, the tailback, Glanton tries. No, he did not make it. The Tennessee defense rising to the occasion. And it will be third down. Make that fourth down and goal. Fourth down and goal. Nothing to nothing. And let's take a second look at the defensive line play of the Volunteers. 51, that was McKenzie. Here comes Clark over the top. Coming from behind, it's Sims. But the Volunteers keep him from penetrating the goal line, but not by much. Now here comes Dewberry, quieting the crowd. Well, Tennessee jumps off sides. Football touches that goal line. It is a touchdown. Well, that he showed you how much it is, about an inch. So that will go down as one penalty for no yards. The scoreboard tells you the story as the Pride of the Southland Band, the other end of the football field, 150 yards away, trying to cheer the Volunteers on as here comes Georgia Tech. Nothing to nothing. Fourth down goal. Inches short. Only an inch away. Where's a hunt? Levette. Touchdown, Georgia Tech. Georgia Tech jumps on top of Tennessee as smashing in comes the tailback Levette, his 40th touchdown. The extra point is up, and it is good. There's timeout on the field with a score. Georgia Tech 7, Tennessee nothing. The second quarter finds Tennessee moving with the football. It's second down 7. Johnny Jones right side, 20, spinning. This Johnny Jones down to the 22-yard line. So Jones, who comes into this game 38 yards short of becoming the all-time career rushing leader at Tennessee, gets a big hole. And out there in front leading the interference, you'll see the blocking. Now you'll see Jones stopped by Travis, but he moves for a gain of 16 yards. And it's first down, Tennessee. 7-0, Tech on top, Tennessee moving. Down near the 20-yard line of the Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets. Tony Robinson at quarterback. The standing tailback is Jones. This is Howard, and Howard lunges over right guard, and he pounds forward for what appears to be about a 5-yard pickup, and it will become for Tennessee second down and 5 at the 17. It's Howard again on a cross buck, and he has the ball at the 10, and William Howard crashes down to the 8-yard line. A freshman from Lima, Ohio, now has carried the ball 3 times for 17 yards. Let's take a second look. You'll see the standoff, and you'll see the blocking up front, and we'll check that a guard or center. It seems to be, and is, Raleigh McKenzie, the center, who made the big block, and there comes William Howard. Part of 11,000-plus Tennessee fans, a crowd in the vicinity of 50,000 on hand for this game. First down goal, Tennessee. Oh, great defensive play by Georgia Tech as Johnny Jones. So Tennessee will have it. Second down, goal to go. 7-0 the score in favor of Georgia Tech. Robinson behind McKenzie, back to throw. Looking. Robinson pumps the pass. It is complete. That's Charles Wilson, the freshman from Pritchard, Alabama, who's come on in the backfield relieving Johnny Jones. There you'll see, nice move by Wilson. You just got a glimpse of it. Now he frees himself, makes the catch right there, juggling the ball, reaches out to pull it back. Cleve Pounds is one of the defenders, and Tennessee will have it third down and goal. Third and goal, Tennessee at the Tech 6-yard line. The Engineers lead by a score of 7-0 in the second quarter. Tony Robinson. On the option, we'll keep 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Give him 6. Touchdown, Tony Robinson. second look, pulling there 67, Bill Mayo. And he opens up the path, and there you see, slashing into the end zone, Tony Robinson, the Tallahassee junior, giving Tennessee a touchdown. There you see it from the end zone, and you see Tennessee just wiped out the defensive line on the right side. So here's Reveiz on to attempt the extra point, and it is perfect. And so it's a tie ball game as Tennessee, which fell behind 7-0, is now back in it at 7-7, moving 70 yards in 11 plays to tie the score at 7-7. Jones now has carried the ball 5 times for 20 yards. Tony Robinson 2 for 8. Howard 3 for 17. The Vols will be kicking off. Fans from all over the country on hand to see Tennessee play. And there you see a lot of them in the end zone cheering on the Volunteers as Reveiz, the senior from Miami, will be kicking off. Here it is. Going to be a bouncer, a squibber. 5, 10, Lilly 15, Lilly crunched. 46, Messimer, and 7, White. So Georgia Tech in a 7-7 game goes on offense, first down, 10 to go at the Tech 24-yard line. Dewberry at quarterback. Looking over Tennessee's defense, this is Dewberry. Looking, in trouble. Dewberry roaming out left. There's Duncan, 31, sack. Dewberry thrown for a loss, and let's take a second look. The secondary doing a job on the receivers. There's Dale Jones forcing him out of the pocket. Duncan is covering. He gets him by the shirt, and then let's take a third look and see the players who sack the fine Georgia Tech junior, John Dewberry. Duncan, 31. I think that's Scott, 65, helping out. Anyway, it's a loss of 10, and it becomes second down and 20. Dewberry on the quarterback draw, not much there. Maybe a couple of yards. Third down and a long, long way to go. Georgia Tech 7, Tennessee 7. Third down play for the Engineers. Levette in motion. The handoff. And coming up the middle is Passarella. Passanella it is, carrying forward, but it's far, far short of the first down.
Deep for Tennessee, number one, Andre.
Into punt will be Snow. Deep for Tennessee will be Andre Kramer. Second quarter of the game at Grant Field. The score is tied at 7-7. Tennessee last week winning over Alabama. Last week Auburn fell behind 41-0 at halftime to Auburn, and then came back to lose the game, but scoring some 34 points in the second half. Here's the kick, Kramer. Great move, Kramer, to the near side, cuts back to the interior, and is tackled. Andre Kramer, freshman from Baltimore, Maryland, returning the punt right at 18 yards, and Tennessee is in excellent field position. The concentration of the receiver, the move. He breaks through the first wall. Cuts back almost one more stride, and he might have gone for even greater distance. But as it is, Kramer returns at 18 yards, and Tennessee has the ball first down and 10 to go. Ball resting at the Volunteer 49-yard line. The score is tied at 7-7. B.B. Cooper, pass midfield into Tech territory to the 48-yard line, where he is tackled. And once again, that's swilling in there on the stop. Tennessee has the football. Tony Robinson behind the center, McKenzie. Todd Upton is in there as an offensive guard on the right side. Wilkerson back to throw. Robinson waiting, pumping, looking, throwing, complete. Cooper. And B.B. Cooper rambles past the 40-yard line, down further into Tech territory. And that's a pickup of 11 yards and a first down. A second look. The offensive line, pass protecting. Slipping up into the pocket, Robinson. Here you see the strength of the junior quarterback, and you'll see the running ability of B.B. Cooper. Tennessee will have the ball first down and 10 to go at the Georgia Tech 37-yard line. The gain for 11 yards. Jones, misdirection, breaks it. 5, 10, 15. It's Johnny Jones carrying the ball for 19 yards up the middle. 6 carries, 39 yards, and with that play, Johnny Jones becomes the all-time career rushing leader, surpassing Kurt Watson by 1 yard. Johnny Jones, great moving and setting his blocking well, and Jones carries for 19 on a first down. 7-7 the score. Tennessee moving with the ball. There you see it at the 19-yard line. Georgia Tech with 3 down linemen. Robinson spots the change in the defensive alignment and is checking off. Robinson. Jones, not much there. He squirms around the corner and gets a yard or two. Second down and 9. 7-7 the score in the second quarter. Ball rests at the right at the 17-18-yard line. Jones runs through one tackle, but there's Travis with a fine open field stop of the slicing senior, and so it will be third down upcoming with the score remaining 7-7.
Jones was stopped by number 8.
There's the pitch. He tried to get to the corner, and there you can see beating the block was one defender forcing him wide, and here's Travis to make the stop in the gap. Third down, 7-7 the score. Tennessee with the ball. Robinson surveys the defense. His team in the I formation. Tennessee might have taken a little too much time to get the play underway. The whistle is sounded. Delay of game, Tennessee, 5-yard penalty. And so the Volunteers have it third down and 14 yards to go. Robinson. Jones, outside, stumbles, cracks it down, and it is short of the first down, so fourth down is coming up, and let's take a second look. Robinson playing there against Pike, the defending outside linebacker, tried to get him to commit, but Pike played it very well. The pitch goes to Jones, and reacting well defensively, Georgia Tech has throttled the Volunteers. And here is Fuad Reveiz to attempt a 32-yard field goal. Reveiz has made 11 consecutive field goals after missing the season's first try, a 63-yard effort. Sells, kick in the air. The kick by Reveiz is good. There's time out on the field with a score. Tennessee 10, Georgia Tech 7. Tech has taken the kickoff after the field goal by Reveiz, moving with the ball, third down. In Tech territory, this is Dewberry. It is complete. That's Wise who makes the catch. Third down play. And a money play indeed. Dewberry with good protection. There you see in the pocket. There's the pass. You'll see breaking to the outside. Wise right on time. And a beautifully executed pass. Charles Davis rides him out of bounds. But Georgia Tech converts the third down into first down and 10 in Tennessee territory. Tennessee leads 10-7. Hand off. Passanella through the left side. Not much there this time. Maybe a yard or two. And it will be second down. There you see Lee North. Well, there are a lot of Volunteers. Lee North, the former Vols center. Dewberry. Pump. Fake. Pitch. Left side. Complete. Passanella moving forward for a gain on the play of 10 yards, and that will be enough for a first down. Tennessee leads 10-7. Let's take a second look. Richard Cooper putting the pressure on, keeping it in the pocket, but then Dewberry arches the pass. They've got the screen set. Terry Brown returning to action after missing. There's Messimer. And then coming from behind, a blast. Probably that looked like Dale Jones. And so Georgia Tech will have it with the first down. Tennessee leads by 3. The ball rests at the Volunteer 30-yard line. Dewberry Here comes the blitz with Benton. The long pass is incomplete. That's Norton, the intended receiver. 14, Brown. One is Kramer. So Tech will have it. Trailing 10-7, second down at 10. Dewberry. Good runs. Going to throw the football, man wide open. Touchdown, Georgia Tech. The touchdown pass from Dewberry to Lee. And Georgia Tech, which led 7-0, only to fall behind 10-7, now goes back on top of the Volunteers in Atlanta. Dewberry is a running threat. And there you'll see Tennessee's deep back committed slightly to the run. And that allowed Gary Lee to come wide open and to stride untouched into the end zone for the score to give Georgia Tech the lead. It's 13-10 in favor of the Ramblin' Wreck from Georgia Tech. In to attempt the extra point. It is up and it is good. And Georgia Tech is back on top of Tennessee. It's 14-10. And the Tech cheering section comes alive. As Bell, who made the extra point, will come nubbing a kick. B.B. Cooper, nice play, Cooper 20. Cooper back to the 25, Cooper to the 30. Cooper carries the ball out to the 34-yard line. Alert play by B.B. Cooper, a senior from Huntsville, Alabama. The Volunteers have, about a minute, 16 seconds to go in the first half. Ball at the Volunteer 34-yard line. Robinson setting up. The pass is incomplete. Second down and 10 yards to go for Tennessee with the score in the football game. The Vols have it first down and 10 to go, the seventh first down of the game. Robinson, pumping, passing, that's complete. The catch is made by Jeff Smith, the junior tight end from Milan, Tennessee. A pickup on the play of 6 yards. Final seconds of the first half, Tech leading by 14-10. Robinson. Pass is complete. Howard at the 40. Howard at the 35. Cuts to the inside and is cracked as he gets downfield. Now Tennessee's going to have to ask for a timeout, and the Volunteers stop the clock. The clock is stopped. Let's take a second look. Robinson releasing the pass just as he was bombarded. And Howard getting stronger. There's the pass play from Robinson to Smith. And now Tennessee stops the clock. Tennessee uses a timeout. Let's spot the ball for you as it's brought in. And the official puts it down at the 28-yard line. There you see 4 seconds left to go in the first half of the game. Georgia Tech leads 14-10. 2 years ago, on the final play in the first half here at Georgia Tech, Fuad Reveiz successfully kicked a 60-yard field goal. Now Reveiz will be attempting a 45-yard field goal to cut the gap down to one. Snapping Farmer, holding Sells. You'll be able to watch it from the end zone. There it is. It is good as the first half comes to a close. We'll be back with halftime comments. The score, 14-13 in just 1 minute. A field goal, and you'll see the ball spotted there at the 45-yard line. That's because Reveiz was roughed. And let's take a second look right here and show you. There's Reveiz. This is back in the first half. And there you'll see Reveiz is knocked down by the rusher. And that results in the 5-yard penalty to commence the second half. So here's Reveiz kicking off. Tennessee trails by one, Tech with the ball. And this will be Lilly, and he is met with authority by the freshman from Graysville, Tennessee, Ray County High School, Jesse Messimer. Tech with the ball. Crisscross handoff, that's Levette. And he rambles forward for a gain of 16 yards on the play. Levette now, in 15 carries, has amassed 84 yards. Robert Levette. Weaving, moving. Now watch the cutback. He fakes it. Now he comes with the cutback. Robert Levette. Xander made the tackle, but it's a first down for Georgia Tech. great running back. Now the fullback has the ball. Pounding forward comes Passanella. He transferred from Northern Arizona to Scottsdale Junior College, then to Georgia Tech, and was a nose guard for 3 years. Lovett, well, Tennessee, very well played on that play by the Volunteers. 65 Scott, 45 Zander, 51 McKenzie. Lovett able to pick up only a yard or two. Third down, 6 yards to go. Tech leading 14-13. Tennessee coming with McKenzie blitzing. The pass downfield is dropped. It was intended for Wilkins, the tight end. The pass is incomplete, and Georgia Tech is faced with fourth down. Andre Kramer is deep for Tennessee. Snow to punt for Georgia Tech. And the kicking game has certainly been a factor. Field goals, quick kick of 65 yards, fine punts for both distance and positioning by Snow. Gets this one away. Kramer under the ball, 18. Looking for a wall, Kramer 20. Kramer 25. And Kramer moves out close to the 30-yard line, and there you'll see a flying penalty flag. Georgia Tech leads Tennessee by a score of 14-13. There the indication is that it is a personal foul, face mask violation against Georgia Tech, tacking on 15 yards. And Tennessee picks up excellent field position. First possession of the second half. Ball rests at the Volunteer 43-yard line. Robinson, his team in the eye, Johnny Jones. Outside, 45, 50, 45. Jones at the football. Moving it down to the 41-yard line of the Engineers. Johnny Jones. You'll see the pulling guards now, the cutback there. Now you'll see weaving outside is Jones. Now he accelerates. There you'll see Jones with the cutback, with the body lean, with the power, and with a gain of 16 yards. 11 carries, 64 yards now for Johnny Jones. Tennessee trails by a point. Howard fumble. Georgia Tech recovers the ball. The handoff mishandled, and Howard never really had the ball. Let's take a second look. There you see the ball just ricochets out onto the field, and it's recovered by Georgia Tech. There's time out of the field with the score, Tech 14, Tennessee 13. The opening has stopped Georgia Tech twice after an exchange of punts. We pick up the action with Tennessee. Moving with the football as Robinson drops to throw. The pass by Robinson. It's complete. William Howard makes the catch. And on third down, Howard moves for a 9-yard gain. William Howard, freshman from Lima, Ohio. A penalty marker down on this play. Let's take a second look. Robinson, again that offensive line, 70 is up to. Here's the pass. Now Howard makes the catch. Pounds comes over, making the tackle, knocking him out of bounds, and there might very well be a spearing personal foul, and that's exactly what it is. 15-yard penalty tacked on to the 9-yard gain, and Tennessee has it first down and 10 to go. The Volunteers first and 10. The ball rests at the 34-yard line. Let's spot it as Tennessee comes to the line. Mark it at the 45-yard line. 45-yard line of Georgia Tech. Robinson. Waiting. The pass complete. That's Eric Swanson, Tennessee. The junior college transfer from San Bernardino, California. Picks off the pass from Robinson. 11-yard gain, and it's first down for the Volunteers. Again, good protection. Good throw. Good catch. Good move by Swanson. Good execution. Tennessee trailing 14-13, but moving. Robinson again setting up. In trouble. Dances right. Looks. Will run and skips out of bounds. With a little help there from Lilly of Georgia Tech. A gain on the play of 5 yards by the junior quarterback. You'll see Robinson looking over his receivers. Nice pressure from Swilly. Good athletic ability by Robinson, skirting to the outside. Picks up a block from Jeff Smith downfield and is shoved out of bounds. Second down, 5. Johnny Jones lashing through the left side of the line, and he rams it for a gain of 4. And so now Tennessee will have the ball. Third down and one. Third and one at the 24-yard line. Georgia Tech 14, Tennessee 13. There you'll see the indication. It's not really 1 yard. It's less than that. So the ball's come to the line. Full house backfield. Well, the left side move. Carrying the ball, Howard. He's got a first down, but the penalty marker is down. And it appeared to me that the left side of Tennessee's offensive line was just about a quarter of a count early. Illegal procedure, Tennessee, 5-yard penalty. And so now Tennessee has it third down. But 5 yards and a foot to go. Tech leading. Robinson setting up to throw, looking, stumbling, pumping, running, giving ground all the way back out there, carrying the football, 35, 30. Robinson lowers his head, dies, it'll be close. Let's see where they mark the ball. He had to get it past the 24-yard line for the first down. It was third down, 5 and a foot. And the officials indicate that it will be first down, 10 to go. First and 10 for the Volunteers, still trailing 14 to 13, nearing the end of the third canto. Pitch Jones, not much there, covered well defensively by Georgia Tech. Little if any gain on the play by Tennessee. There's time out on the field with the score, Tech 14, Tennessee 13. Now moving into the fourth quarter. It's third down, 7, Tennessee with the ball in Tech territory as Robinson fades to throw, rips the pass, complete. Eric Swanson again. Beautiful route run by Swanson, a combination along the far sideline as Tennessee now in the fourth period will move toward the south end of the football field. The combination route teaming up Swanson and McGee. Robinson fades, waits, beautiful protection. Coming across there, you'll see Swanson. And there you see downfield, it was McGee. And it's Rutland who knocks Swanson out of bounds. That gain is good for 22 yards. First down for Tennessee. The 17th first of the game for the Volunteers. William Howard pounding, grinding, ramming. And the Volunteers move it for a pickup on the play of 6 yards. The score remains 14-13. Georgia Tech leading Tennessee. Fourth quarter of this game at Grant Field. Building and building, as so many games have throughout this 1984 campaign for Tech, for Tennessee, and for many college teams across the country. The ball's to the line. It'll be for Tennessee, second down and 4 yards to go. This is Howard, 15, bumps his own man and pounds forward. Should be enough for the first down. William Howard, the Lyman, Ohio freshman, now in 8 carries, has gained 33 yards. And Tennessee will have it first down and 10 to go. Howard will go limping to the sideline. Let's take a second look. Howard. Galbreath is playing in the offensive line. Upton is in there. Wilkerson is in there. Mayo has gone out with an injury. As the injuries continue to plague the Volunteers, but Tennessee keeping the drive alive, first down. Robinson sees that defensive switch from a 3 to a 5-man line. Here's the blitz. And the handoff goes to B.B. Cooper. Tennessee picked up the blitz, and had he been there a step earlier, it could have been a big, big gain. As it is, Cooper picks up 2 yards. The score in the game is 14-13 in favor of Georgia Tech in the fourth period of the game. Robinson. All right, he's checking off. He sees another defensive switch. They've gone back to that 3-down line situation. Here's the blitz. Here's Robinson. Here's the pass. Touchdown! Big on it. Tennessee goes up the middle. And Robinson checked off at the line of scrimmage. And he diagonaled Vince Carter, the freshman from Nashville, through the middle. Here you'll see the look to the outside. And there you'll see the cut to the inside by Carter. He had half a step. And now he's got 6 points. Tennessee pulls on top of Georgia Tech. And racing to the sideline is Vince Carter. with his touchdown reception. And now the Volunteers thinking about things, trailing, I should say, leading by 5 points. And Tennessee, which scored a two-point conversion a week ago to beat Alabama 28-27, is going to try for two. Robinson rolling right, pumps the pass, give it to him. Charles Wilson, the two-point extra point try succeeds, and Tennessee leads by a score of 21-14. Second look at ground level. Robinson arches the pass. Excellent reception there by Charles Wilson. Now let's go to the end zone for a third look at this. And this is really an outstanding catch by Wilson. Watch him go into the air, twist his body, pull it into his body with both hands, and Tennessee pulls on top by 7 points. Have played extremely well in the second half. A couple of turnovers along the way have hurt Tennessee as far as building a lead. Georgia Tech ever dangerous, of course, particularly their All-American running back, Robert Levent. Fuad Reveiz, who has kicked 13 straight field goals now this year and in this game has moved past Gene McEvern to become the all-time scoring leader for Tennessee. As far as career points is concerned, kicks off. Georgia Tech. This is Lilly. 15, 20. Breaking it. Lilly is pulled out. A saving tackle just before he breaks it. And that could have really been a turnaround. This is Lilly. They open up the corridor. Creamer can't quite get there. And the tackle is a saving one indeed. McDaniel makes the stop. Okay, Georgia Tech with the ball. They bring the tight end into the boundary left. Dewberry looking over a four-man, five-man line. Pitch Levent at the corner. Levent at the 40. Levent breaks it. Beautiful cut. Levent 45-40, 35-30. Levent to the 20, to the 15, to the 10. Sims knocks him out of bounds at the two-yard line. Robert Levent, 60 yards. 11 carries. He now has a total of 150 yards in this game. Watch this move on the corner. Passanella gave him a block right there. Tight roping the near sideline. Now, just barely misses stepping on the side boundary. Button hooks around and turns it on. Levent, Clark chasing, Cooper chasing with good speed, but it's Sims who angles across to knock him out of bounds at the two-yard line. Tennessee 21. Georgia Tech 14. Dewberry at quarterback. The man in motion is Norton. This is Dewberry all by himself. He'll walk into the end zone. Touchdown, Yellow Jackets. Now suddenly it can change. Beautiful execution. Tennessee, of course, keying on Levent. Why not? And Dewberry is all by himself to skip into the end zone, and Georgia Tech pulls within a point. Over 5 minutes, 7 minutes, 49 seconds all told to go, and Georgia Tech is going to go for the extra point in the tie. Bell in to attempt the extra point. Lots of time to go, and of course, Georgia Tech hoping to get the football again, and hoping, if for nothing else, a field goal. Snap down. Kick is in the air. The kick is good. There's timeout on the field with a score. Georgia Tech 21, Tennessee 21. Game this year. This one is exciting and tight and tense and anybody's ball game. It's now tied at 21-21. Georgia Tech will be kicking off. Here is Bell. Here's the kick. Tennessee under the ball. Wait a minute. They run together. That's Wilson. He almost fumbled that football as he comes forward. He's knocked down and Tennessee's going to maintain possession as Charles Wilson was juggling that ball when he was cracked down, and he and Carter had run together receiving it. So Tennessee will have the ball at the 20-yard line. The score is tied at 21-21. Jones, no. Well, the touchdown drive by Georgia Tech has obviously excited the defense as well as the Tech fans. And Tennessee's Johnny Jones is stopped for only a yard gain. He now has 99 yards and 18 carries. Tennessee, second down, 9. Score tied 21-21. Robinson back to throw. The pass complete. Smith, a penalty marker down. Smith. Jeff Smith, the tight end, who is really coming into his own as a receiver for Tennessee. Beautiful catch coming across the middle that time. Let's take a second look. Robinson setting up. Throwing the ball. Watch Smith. Pulling it down. Beautifully. He is really blasted. But it's all for naught because Tennessee was guilty of illegal procedure. And so that pass play, which gained 29 yards, is nullified. And here's the 5-yard step off against the Volunteers. So instead of first and 10 at midfield, it is going to become for Tennessee second down and right at 14 yards to go. The score is 21-21 in the final 7 minutes of this game at Grant Field. Tony Robinson surveying a 3-man rush. Robinson, pass complete. Nice move. Tennessee with the football and coming forward. Who is that? That's Smith again. Jeff Smith with the catch from his tight end position now has received yet another pass. That will be 5 catches for Smith thus far in the football game. Let's take a second look. Smith breaking a tackle, showing running ability, and there you'll see tucks the ball in to protect it. A gain of 13, but Tennessee needed a mile and a quarter. So it will be, there you can see, third down upcoming and right at a yard and a half to go. The Volunteers fighting the clock, fighting the Tech defense. It's tied 21-21. Robinson. Wilson. I think he got it. That's Charles Wilson with second effort. And he battles for what from here appears to be a first down. The score is 21-21. They're still lining it up, but for absolute security's sake, they ask for the measurement. It is first down, Tennessee. The Volunteers, the Engineers, battling it out at Georgia Tech. Robinson, handoff. Wilson, ramming the middle, and plunges forward for a gain of a couple of yards on the play. So for Tennessee, it will be second down and 8. Less than 5 minutes to go. Through the left side, slashes Charles Wilson. And Wilson now has moved for yardage. That should be enough for the first down. They're lining it up again. He has carried the ball now 5 times for 28 yards. Wilson limping a bit as he returns to the huddle, and now will be relieved as Tennessee has it first down. Jones is popped. Great defensive play. Beautiful, beautiful defensive play that time by Donnie Chisholm, that middle guard. Jones is blasted. You'll see Chisholm come open right here, clean and right on top of Jones. And credit Jones for even holding on to the football as he was in the middle of accepting the exchange. Georgia Tech defense getting tough. Tennessee 21, Georgia Tech 21. Robinson fumble. I don't know. I think Tennessee recovered that ball, and was that? It was the alert McKenzie. That's the second time in this football game that Raleigh McKenzie, who is truly having an outstanding year as an offensive center for Tennessee, has recovered a bobble. Well, Tennessee has it third down and long, long yardage to go. 21-21. The ball at the Volunteer 39-yard line. Robinson waiting, looking, passing, complete. That's Carter. Vince Carter, who scored a touchdown moments ago, comes up with a third down catch. And Tennessee, struggling, keeps the drive alive. A second look. Beautiful cut to the outside by Carter. Written down by Pounds, but it's a first down for the Volunteers. There's the story. First and 10 at the 44. Fourth period, 2:28 left, 21-21 the score. Doug Matthews, who is in contact with Tennessee's offensive staff in the press box, visiting with Tony Robinson and Johnny Majors as Georgia Tech is using a timeout to align itself defensively. Tennessee has the ball first down, the 22nd first down of the game. For the Vols, the give is to Howard. And he plows forward for 3 yards on the play. And Tennessee will have it second down and 7. The ball is at the 41-yard line of Georgia Tech. That will make it a 58-yard field goal. In case Tennessee... Well, let's see. Smith, a diving catch, but it's ruled that he did not have control of the ball when he came down or did not drag his feet. Let's take a second look right here. Robinson's pass. Now, if 1 foot comes down in bounds and he has control, it's ruled that he's out of bounds. The pass is incomplete. Third down, 6. Third and 6. 21-21. Final minute to this game. Robinson. Long pass against the blitz. It is incomplete. Tennessee warning pass interference not to be allowed. As Georgia Tech came with an all-out blitz, and Tennessee has it fourth down and 6. And the Vols are not going to try a field goal. There's a wind in the face of Reveiz if he were to try it. And, of course, Tech would get the ball right back here if the field goal is missed. Fourth down, Robinson. Pass, Smith. Breaks a tackle, 30, 25, 20, 15. That's Jeff Smith, who ranges downfield. And the senior, junior tight end comes up with a big, big fourth down play. He's injured on the play. Jeff Smith. As Robinson dumps the pass out here to Smith. Now watch him. Twist free. And then Jeff Smith racing downfield is tackled at the 11. And there you'll see the hit, which probably brought around the injury. Here's a third look. Jeff Smith, watch this twisting move right here. I'm not sure he had the first down when he caught the ball. He does now. And he has much, much more. Jeff Smith ranging along the sideline. A stiff arm trying to free himself for the final 8 or 10 yards. He's down. Well, I don't know. But anyway, he's injured on the play, and trainer Tim Caron is out there visiting with him. Tennessee will have the ball. It will be first down. 10 to go. 1:39 left in the football game. Tennessee is out of timeouts. Smith, under his own power, leaving. What a day he has had. 6 catches, 89 yards, and he had one reception that was wiped off, a 29-yard catch, wiped off because of a penalty. The tight end, the big, big factor in this game, particularly in the second half, where Tennessee has converted successfully on 9 of 10 third downs and 1 fourth down play. Johnny Jones moving it to the middle of the field, bumping it forward for a gain of 3. Now, Georgia Tech, of course, has to think about the clock, and that's exactly what the engineers are doing. They ask for a timeout because they know that Tennessee is going to have, if nothing else, a chance for a field goal. And if the field goal is good, then Georgia Tech would like it to come as soon as possible so the engineers will have some time left. The chess match continues at Grant Field. 21-21, Johnny Jones carrying the ball forward with both hands. The Vols have turned it over twice on fumbles in this football game and once on an interception. Tennessee taking its time. Now the Vols are really not in a hurry because Tennessee knows that it's going to have its chance to win the game if nothing else, a field goal. Third down play, Jones just stuttering in the middle, moves it down to about the 4-yard line. And Tennessee will be sending into the game Fuad Reveiz. Tech uses a timeout. That's its final timeout, I think. 38 seconds. Reveiz has been successful on 13 straight field goals after missing his first try this year, a 63-yard try. And now he'll be attempting a field goal, which could give Tennessee the lead in this football game. It will be a 22-yard attempt. Farmer will snap. Sells will hold. Reveiz will kick. All important. Good! Tennessee 24, Georgia Tech 21. And that snap, there's a penalty marker down on the play. Now let's wait and see what it is. I believe that the left side of the Tech line could have jumped offside. Sells is there talking about it. Offsides, Georgia Tech. so had that snap, which to me appeared to be a little bit off the mark. And Sells, who has those great hands and the supreme confidence, I think perhaps that's as important as anything for a holder to have the confidence. He got the snap, he put it down on the tee, and Reveiz knocked it home. Reveiz now 14 straight field goals this year, and Tennessee 38 seconds away from a second straight consecutive come from behind in the final period victory. It's been that kind of year. Well, the Vol fans are up, 11,000 of them, with some 22,000 orange and white Shakers at full speed. But Tech is here too. Keep in mind that when Tennessee went ahead earlier in this quarter, Tech came back to score and tied it in two plays. Here's the kick, Reveiz a bouncer. Tech, the ball skips by, another receiver, picked up finally by Malden, back up the middle, he's tripped up and dropped. Georgia Tech will have the ball. Dewberry, here's Levette angling out to the near side. He's the man they'll want to go to, if at all possible. Setting up Dewberry. Pass across the middle is incomplete. Intended for the tight end, Wisenant. The clock will be stopped with the incomplete forward pass. Messimer was over covering. And of course, Tennessee has a prevent defense with that secondary back, 25 yards. Back to throw, Dewberry. He's going to run. Dewberry running up the middle, cuts back, and is dropped there by McKenzie. He jumps up as Dewberry picks up his team's 16th first down, 9 carries, 16 yards net. The clock is stopped with a marking of the ball. Tennessee stays in that deep defense. Dewberry looking deep, nobody there. Pass, Wisenant. Wisenant is knocked down inbounds at the 40-yard line. The clock continues to roll. The score is Tennessee 24, Georgia Tech 21. The fans begin to count it down. Tech lines up. The football game is over as the ball goes sailing out of bounds. We'll be back as you see the final score, 24-21. Tennessee now 4-2-1, Tech 3-3-1. We'll be back to talk to Coach Jonathan Majors in just 1 minute.